Good morning, welcome to today's special meeting for Monday, June 13th, 10 a.m. Please rise for the Pledge Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Madam Clerk, roll call for attendance.
Franciski?
Present.
Ventura? Vasquez?
Present.
Garcia? Orange?
Present.
Maldonado? Medina?
Present.
Parks?
Present.
Santos?
Present. For the record, Madam Clerk, I did receive a call from Councilwoman Maldonado, and she did have some family issues to take care of, and our council secretary received a phone call from Councilman Ventura, and he stated he will not be here this morning. So with that being said, Madam Clerk, we only have one thing that we're dealing with, and that was the mayor called a special meeting. And I believe in regards to a resolution, you want to read that by title only?
A resolution authorizing and designating Kimberly K. Anderson as the official city of the East Chicago signatory on city deposits. That's resolution number 2011-008. Sponsor Mayor Copeland.
Okay, do we have somebody from the mayor's office here?
No.
Joseph Allegretti, Corporation Counsel. Good morning, Common Council. The resolution is, of course, as it indicates that there's been a passing of the torch at the City Controller's Office. Mr. Pecor's last day was Friday, and effective Saturday at midnight, the mayor appointed Kimberly Anderson to be the new city controller. That, of course, is an executive function. The mayor has the authority to appoint all department heads, including the city controller. However, since the Common Council does control all finances of the city, for purposes of banking and controlling those finances and resources, the bank desires to have the Common Council acknowledge and appoint and authorize the city signatory on all bank accounts. That is what this resolution accomplishes. It provides that the Common Council acknowledge and authorize the city controller as the signatory on all bank accounts, and that's, in a nutshell, is what it is.
Any questions? Councilwoman Orange?
Will they be replacing Kim Anderson,
her position? Will that, or is that position going away?
That's right. She is the deputy controller, and I'm sorry I can't answer that, but that's a good question. I don't know if Carla Morgan knows the answer to that. I don't know if we know. But that position is vacancy, the position of deputy controller, and I don't know if that's going to be filled.
Any more questions? Councilwoman Medina?
Mr. Allegretti, on this resolution, it indicates that she will be interim city controller?
It does. The mayor appointed her interim, I guess, in the sense that she's interim. I suppose all department heads are interim in that they can be they serve at the pleasure of the mayor. He stopped calling me interim corporation counsel a few weeks ago, but he might start calling me interim corporate counsel again. I don't know. I mean, I don't think there's any other significance to that other than it's interim, perhaps next year he might make at the beginning of a new term of office, he might make a change. But those were his wishes, and that's why it's contained in the resolution. But she does act with full authority as city controller.
Right, and that was going to be my next question. Because by statute, I mean, it is implied that all department heads are at the will of the mayor, at his pleasure.
She is the acting fully authorized and by...
Is it necessary to describe that temporary position that way?
Those are the mayor's wishes, that she be acting as interim. And I know there's some discussion about her salary, and I suppose that's something that may become to the council at some future time. But those are the mayor's wishes, that she be designated as interim, but not to, however, diminish her authority to having full authority to act as the city controller and all, and perform her statutory function. But that's what I know.
So by describing it as interim, what salary would she be drawing?
I don't know exactly what the salary is, but it's my understanding her salary, there will be a reduction from, she will not make the salary that her predecessor made. It will be reduced. I've not been informed what that amount is. I think maybe that's the subject of some discussions right now.
So as we speak, what salary is she drawing?
I don't know. It's something less than what Mr. Pecoro was making.
Because what I could recall, didn't we change the salary ordinance?
Right, and
eliminating interim positions, salaries?
Right. I think the mayor does have the authority to reduce the salary, just can't increase it. And I think the mayor has, plus the city controller gets other agencies contribute to her compensation. I know the water utility contributes a portion because she's serves as a fiscal officer. She also serves by statute the fiscal officer of the sanitary district, and the sanitary makes a contribution to her total pay. I think that total pay is described in the salary ordinance. And I think the mayor is considering, as I indicate, as a cost-saving measure to provide that there be some scale, but at least at the onset of her service as city controller, she not make the same be paid the same amount as the outgoing city controller. And other than that, I can't answer the question. I apologize.
Well, if you can't answer it, then who can?
I suppose the mayor can, and it's something that's going to be resolved very quickly. Of course, she's going to get a paycheck coming up, and then I guess we will all know. But I know that the last time I spoke to the mayor about it, he was considering all sources of income she gets from those other agencies. I think she also does some work for Healthy Start or Healthy Choice. The city controller serves as fiscal officer of that entity, and that they also contribute to the total compensation of the city controller. And I think the mayor is trying to, as a cost saving measure, is considering some modification of the current salary structure, and there is going to be some kind of a reduction.
Okay, Mr. Allegretti, maybe you could answer this question. If, in fact, he is going to reduce that salary, does that need approval from this body?
I don't think so. I think the mayor can reduce but not increase.
Okay, and then at any point, if he chooses to make her permanent, will we have another resolution before us?
No, I think that is an executive function. This resolution... only designates her as the city signatory and the person who writes checks on city bank accounts. You will certainly participate in her salary this summer, and what the salary for the city controller, as along with all other city officials, are going to be paid. And so it's, you know, I mean, the council's authority on that subject is not changed. That's statutory, and you're as familiar with that process as anyone.
Yes, but when we have a play of words here with interim, you know, it was on this, they tried to create a salary for that. It was turned down, then it was taken off.
I don't think it's...
I don't see whether, you know, I know Ms. Anderson is very capable of doing that job. She's been in that office for many, many, many years.
Yeah, I think the mayor has a lot of confidence in her, and I know you do, too.
I just don't appreciate when we call people interim. I mean, if you're going to make her the city controller, I mean, that's a very, very, a job requires a lot of responsibility. She should be compensated for doing her job the same way other controllers have been. And I just thank you for answering my question.
And I just assure you, it's not a subterfuge. It is a term of art, and the mayor has used it in the past. As I say, he's described me as interim in the past. I don't want you to read more into it than it is. That's the mayor's choice of words. At some time in the future, I presume, although I shouldn't presume, that interim label may be removed, but she is the acting city controller as of Saturday at the stroke of midnight, and she will do a good job, and she has certainly has the mayor's confidence.
Any more discussion from
Mr. Allegretti? I'm not trying to read more into what it reads. I mean, there's a reason why it's on paper. And
yes,
she's acting now, even after we adopt this resolution, she will continue to be acting.
Right.
Correct?
Interim, yes.
Interim.
Right.
And thank you.
We agree. We're all
any agreeing. More discussion from the council members here? Councilman Parks?
Attorney Allegretti, just quickly, speaking of cost-cutting measures, with Ms. Anderson's accounting and finance background, with her in this office now, will there still be a necessity for a full-time financial consultant in an office?
I think the only one I know that fits that description is Mr. Bennett. Mr. Bennett is here today, and he has always performed other budgetary and financial advice services that do overlap with some of the people in the office, but in some respects are unique in terms of his relationship and knowledge of the system, of the property tax system, and his relationship with the DLGF. And I do not know of any intention by the mayor of changing that. I don't think and the mayor can speak to that. I don't know that I can speak to it intelligently. I know there's been some suggestion it's not going to be totally indefinitely, that there will be some kind of a end of the line for those services. And I think it's the mayor's desire that ultimately all those services be done in-house, but I don't know that there's any termination date. And Mr. Bennett, as we all know, does perform very valuable services for the city.
Any more discussion? Councilwoman Vasquez?
Yes. Mr. Allegretti, correct me if I'm wrong. I got a little confused about you were saying when you were talking about her salary. The other three boards that she sits on, were you saying that her salary, including those three boards, is not going to exceed what Mr. Pecora was making? Should I understand you correctly?
The city controller is one of the offices that gets some contribution to the total compensation package comes from other agencies, because she's, by statute, the controller is the fiscal officer for the sanitary district, for example, so they they pay a portion of her total compensation. What I'm saying is that in the total compensation, I think the State Board of Accounts requires that, for example, even though the mayor's gets a compensation from other agencies that contribute to his total compensation package, the salary ordinance adopted by the Common Council must state that the number contained in the salary ordinance must be the total of the total compensation from all sources. Same with the city controller. I don't know if I'm answering your question, but I think what the mayor intends on doing she will not initially receive the same compensation as her predecessor, the outgoing Mr. Pecora. She will make something less. There will be a scale, and she will be able to, as time goes by, to grow her compensation may increase in that. But as I say, it's going to be ultimately something approved by the salary ordinance adopted by the Common Council.
Thank you.
Any more questions? Madam Clerk, roll call to adopt.
Franciski?
Yes.
Ventura? Vasquez?
Yes.
Orange?
Yes.
Medina?
No.
Parks?
Yes.
Santos?
Yes, motion carries. There's nothing else on the agenda for this morning's special meeting, so the chair will entertain a motion to adjourn.
Second.
Motion made by Councilman Parks, seconded by Councilman Franciski to adjourn. Madam Clerk?
Franciski?
Yes.
Vasquez?
Yes.
Orange?
Yes.
Medina?
Yes.
Parks?
Yes.
Santos?
Yes, motion carries.